joyous morning and blessed Sabbath to you all. Thank you for joining us as we come in his presence with thanksgiving, giving honor, awe, and glory to God, and praise, for he is Elohim, the strong creator God, Jehovah, the relational God, Adonai, master over all, El Bethel, the God of the house of God, El Elyon, the Most High God, El Emuna, the faithful God, El Hakaba, the God of glory, El Haye, the God of my life, Elohim Kadishim, the Holy God, Jehovah Elohim Yeshua, the Lord God of my salvation, Jehovah Jireh, the Lord our provider, Jehovah Mekedeshim, the Lord who sanctifies you, Jehovah Rapha, the Lord our healer, Jehovah Shammah, the Lord is there. Therefore, I praise you among the Gentiles and sing praises to your name. Rejoice and celebrate. Praise our mighty God and give him glory because he's worthy. He's worthy. He's worthy of all our praises. Dear kind and merciful Father, which are in heaven, Lord, we just thank you so much for allowing us to have breath another day. We thank you for waking us up this morning, Lord. We thank you so much, Lord, that we're here, Lord, and that we invoke your spirit to be with us, dear Lord. Lord, we already feel your spirit in the place.
Yes, God.
Lord, we ask that you would please be with everybody that's tuning in on Facebook Live and those who are here in the congregation, dear Lord. We ask that you would let none of us leave the place the same way that we came, dear Lord. Lord, we ask that you would help everybody to realize, those who don't have a church home, Lord, help them to realize that they can't feel your spirit in the place when the service is going on, no matter where they're watching the service at. If they're streaming, Lord, they need to be in the building, Lord. That means whether it's on Sabbath, Saturday, whether it's on Sunday, they need to be in somebody's church building, forsaking
yes,
not
oh
the
God.
Fellowship.
Yes,
Lord,
oh
we're supposed to fellowship.
Yes,
that's
oh
what the Bible
yes,
says.
Oh
we're supposed to fellowship together.
Yes, oh God.
And Lord, so we just ask that you would bless those who don't have a church home. Bless them with
yes,
a church
Lord
home,
Jesus.
Dear Lord. Lord, we ask that you would save those who need to be saved. Heal those who need healing, dear Lord. Lord, we ask that you would be in every aspect of the service, dear Lord. Please accept our sacrifice of praise. In
yes,
the name
God.
Of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
At this time, we're going to do our welcome. So we wish you well as you worship with us. Each day is to be exciting because it's an excellent gift from God.
Yes.
So live like it's your last day and love like Jesus does. Come into God's house, for he cares for you. He's omnipresent. He's always here among us. God's mighty power manifest and magnify your meaning.
Yes,
so come and enjoy your worship experience with God. Together we throw up our hands and praise the Lord. You're an overcomer through our omnipotent God.
Amen.
You'll find our God is your friend. Yes, he is. He's a friend to the friendless. Hallelujah. With wholehearted affection and welcoming arms, get charged up, be comforted, and count your blessings. And those of you on Facebook, thank you for tuning in, and know that you're always welcome here at Family Worship Center, a place where families can imagine what God has in store for you, because God has something in store for everybody on this earth. So let's greet each other with a hug, appropriate kiss, handshake, a fist bump. However you greet each other in the name of the Lord. You know, I've already greeted.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Familiar faces, the young and the old. So happy you joined us in the house of the Lord, where there is hope, health, healing. So take your neighbor's hand, because we're on a mission. It's the master's plan. And you are welcome here. Welcome here. So glad to see you here. You're welcome here.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. All right. At this time, we are going to move into praise and worship. We're going to do a worship song today that is just, it's just touching. It's called Waymaker. Because despite what you may think, despite what you're going through, God is a waymaker. If you lean on him, if you reach out to him, if you love on him, if you let him know that you receive his love, that you receive his open arms, man, there's nothing good that God won't withhold from you. Nothing. And no matter what we go through in this life, God is there for us. He is right there for us. He's just waiting on you to reach out to him.
Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are.
Say it together.
Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are.
Let's declare it together.
Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. You are here, turning lives around. I worship you. I worship you. You are here, mending
Light in the darkness, my God, that's who you
Yes. Minister, Minister First Lady, yes. Guess who he is? He's a way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness.
To God. We have come this morning to lift up the name of Jesus. We have come this morning to pray for this country,
yes,
to pray for you today. We've come to call on the name of Jesus. There's no other name given among men whereby we must be saved.
Yes.
But at the name of Jesus.
At the name of Jesus.
Our hearts are prayer, our hearts and minds are clear as we let us go through the throne of grace today. Lord Jesus, we just come before your throne today saying thank you. Thank you for another opportunity, God, to lay before your throne, God, to come yet boldly, God, believing, God, that you're able to do exceedingly abundantly above whatsoever we ask or think. God, we thank you today, God, that you have spared our lives to be still in the land of the living, God. We thank you, Lord, for giving us the aptitude and the altitude to know that you are the creator, God, and that we are your servants, God, created in your own image. God, we thank you today, Lord, that because of you, we live and move and have our being. We thank you today, God, that no weapon formed against us shall prosper, and that every tongue that shall rise against us in judgment, thou shalt condemn. We thank you today, God, that your name is Jehovah Rapha, the Lord that healeth thee. We thank you today that your name is Jehovah Nissi, our banner today. We thank you today, God, that you are Jehovah Jireh, the Lord that sees the need in advance and provides in a supernatural way. Today, God, we come on behalf of your people. We come on behalf of those that are hurting, those that are in mishap situations. We come in behalf of those that are still struggling with addiction to substance abuse. We come today on behalf of those children that are homeless, those children's parents that are homeless. We come on behalf today for those that are hungry, for those that are trying to make a way in their situation. God, we come today on behalf of the mothers, God, that said, pray for me. I need you to strengthen me, God. We come on behalf today for the fathers, God, that want to be head of their households, God. They want to be leaders for their children. We come today, God, recognizing, God, that we can do all things through Christ, which strengthens us, God. We come today, God, to lift up your people, God. We come today to lift up this nation, God, this in turmoil, God. We come today, God, to pray for the leader of this nation, God, that you will save, that you will deliver him, that you will transform their minds on Capitol Hill, God, that you will touch this impeachment trial, God, that your justice and your truth will prevail, not lies, God, not things that are put under the cover, God. Don't let them cover up, God, what needs to be exposed in the name of Jesus. We come today, God, thanking you for another day that we can know that you are Alpha and Omega, that you are the beginning and the end. We come today to lift up every pastor's wife, God. We come today to lift up the pastor's family, God. We come today to lift up every church, every ministry that's lifting up the name of Jesus, that you will fortify them, God, that you will just revisit them, God, that you will ignite their spirits. We come today on behalf of the Bryant family, God. We lift up Vanessa and her family, God. We lift up every family, God, that was on that plane that went down last Sunday, God, that you would touch them as they go through this difficult time of mourning, this difficult time of bereavement, God. But I know that your word's here. Weeping may endure for a night. I believe joy will come in the morning. We pray, God, that you will bless them to get energized, that you will send forth your comfort, that you will send forth your love, that you will send forth your peace, that you will send forth your strength during this time. We lift up everyone that have dealt with loss in their family thus far. This is the 1st of February, a brand new month, God. We thank you for this month, God, that you're still moving by your power. God, we lift up, God, Family Worship Center, what a place where families can imagine. We lift up every soul that will be attached to us, because everything that's attached to you, Lord, win. According to Kaylin Carson, we win, God. So we thank you for allowing us to win. We thank you for the devil is defeated. Take his hands off our children, our grandchildren, our great-grandchildren. We pray, God, that you will fortify us, God, that we may live for you, God. We thank you today, God, that we're more than conquerors in you, God. We thank you today that you've given us authority to tread upon serpents and scorpions, God, to lay hands on the sick, God, and know we will not be harmed. We thank you today, Lord. For the angel of Christian Unity Baptist Church, we lift up Dr. Antoine Hutchins today. We lift up his leadership. We lift up his family, God, that you will continue to move upon this church. Oh, Father God, we thank you for St. Charles County. We thank you, Father, for Southern PG County. We thank you for sending us people that will come and worship you, that will come and allow your spirit to transform them, that we will be anchors in this community, God. We lift up every soul, God, today, God. Let us, God, raise our spirits, God, today, to know, God, that we are victorious, God. Let us know that we can still win, God. Greater is he that's in us than he that's in the earth. So we thank you for today.
Yes, God.
We thank you for this worship service,
thank
this
you,
worship
Lord.
Experience.
Thank you, Lord.
That you will throw your weight around. Mm-hmm. That your spirit will move from the pulpit to the door.
Yes.
That you will touch every vessel that will walk in this place, everyone that will listen to this sermon, this worship experience, God, everything, God, I need your help in advance, that you will saturate our ears and saturate our spirits.
Yes,
we thank you for this prayer, God. Oh, Father, we ask you, God, to be Jehovah Jireh for this ministry, God. You've given us a vision, God, to move, God. We lift up, oh, God, William B. Wade Elementary School, God.
Yes,
we
Lord.
Lift up every family, God.
Yes.
Oh, Father, we lift up the Washington family and the Tate family specific,
yes.
God. Oh, Father, we lift up Birchwood, God. Senior Living Apartments, God. We lift up everyone that's in our Bible
yes,
study, God.
Yes.
We ask you to touch them, God.
Yes,
heal their bodies. Heal their minds, God. Remove the pain. Remove the difficulty. Save, God. We thank you today, Lord, for this prayer. We love you, Lord. We appreciate you, God. Oh, God, so continue to create in us a clean heart and renew us a right spirit. God, we give this prayer to thee, that you will do what you have to do with it. In the name of Jesus, amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Pastor. That was awesome.
Bless the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Woo! I wish you could feel the spirit up in here. For those who are here, they can feel it. But I wish you could feel it on Facebook Live. You need to come in the building. All right? At this time, it is offering time. Hallelujah. We clap when it's offering time because it is a cheerful time. It's the part of the service where we can participate, where everybody can participate, where we can give back to God what is rightfully his. Because we know we don't want to rob God. We don't want to steal from God. So the purpose of tithing is to teach you always to put God first. Put God first in everything you do. Trust me when I tell you, he will come through for you. You don't even understand. Press down, running over. Give it to give and it will be given. Press down, shake it together, running over. Because when you give to the Lord, he will give you more. He will give you more, running over. He will give you. So cheerfully now bring the tithe and offering, and you'll have blessings running over. Honor the Lord with your wealth and with the first fruits of your crops, your income. You can also give online at Tithely, T-I-T-H-E.L-Y, Tithely. Go to Family Worship Center, a place where families can imagine, and you can give. Or you can give at www.familyworshipcenterimagine.org. Okay? Either one. Thank you so much for your support, your love, your prayers. We appreciate it. We need your prayers. Bring all the tithe into the storehouse, that they may meet in my house, says the Lord of hosts, that I will not pour you out blessing, that you won't have room enough to receive it. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen. Lord, we ask that you will bless these tithes and these offerings, dear Lord, that they may further your use and your purposes, dear Lord, that they may reach souls who are in need, dear Lord, that they will help out, dear Lord, that they would just be a blessing, dear Lord. Lord, we ask that you will be with everybody who had to give and those who had not to give. Lord, we ask that you will magnify what they did give, dear Lord. And Lord, we ask that you will bless those who don't have jobs. Bless them with jobs, Lord, so that they can give to your kingdom, Lord. Because it's all about building up your kingdom, Lord, so that when you come back to get us, Lord, we can all go to heaven. Lord, we ask that you would be with every single person, dear Lord, and inspire them to give, dear Lord, from their heart. And joyfully, dear Lord, not begrudging, not because they don't really want to, they're just doing it to do it, Lord. No, let them do it cheerfully, Lord, joyfully, so that they know that when they give from their heart, that you're going to bless them, you're going to magnify them, dear Lord. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen. All right, at this time, we need everyone to stand, please, for the reading of the word. So the scripture is Zechariah chapter 4, verses 1 through 6 in the Amplified Version. Zechariah chapter 4, verses 1 through 6 in the Amplified Version. And the title of this scripture is The Golden Lampstand and Olive Trees. And the angel who was speaking with me came back and awakened me, like a man who is awakened out of his sleep. He said to me, "What do you see?" I said, "I see, and behold, a lampstand of all of gold, with its bowl for oil on the top of it, and its seven lamps on it with seven spouts, belonging to each of the lamps which are on the top of it. And there are two olive trees by it, one on the right side of the bowl, and the other on its left side, supplying it continuously with oil. So I asked the angel who was speaking with me, 'What are these, my Lord?' Then the angel who was speaking with me answered me, 'Do you not know what these are?' And I said, 'No, my Lord.' Then he said to me, the continuous supply of oil is the word of the Lord to Zerubbabel, prince of Judah, saying, 'Not by might, not by power, but by my spirit, of whom the oil is a symbol,' says the Lord of hosts." May the Lord add a blessing to the hearing and reading of his word. In the name of Jesus, amen.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, saints. Let me get myself together as we prepare for the word of God today. We are grateful to be in the house of the Lord another Sabbath, Saturday. We are grateful because God has allowed us to be in a place to where only God is going to get the glory today. I'm grateful that God has helped me through this week to share the word of God. Amen. Praise God. We're so grateful. This song is by Micah Stanley. And it simply says, we need the glory. We need the glory. I don't know about you today, but we need the glory. Live in my praise. 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 We need your glory to live in my praise. We need to live in my praise. Saturate us, God, right now. Saturate our thoughts. Manifest, Lord. Right now, Lord, we need you to manifest. Don't let your glory depart. Oh, I need his glory. I don't know about you today, saints. I don't know about you that are listening through the stream. I don't know about you today, but we need the glory of God to saturate our hearts today. Woo! Thank you, Lord. Manifest yourself, Lord, today. Manifest yourself today, Lord. Don't let your glory depart. Say to God, if the Lord's presence leaves, we need the glory. Woo! We need the glory. Just pause for a moment wherever you are and just lift up your hands and tell God that you need his glory. You need his glory. You need his glory. You need his glory. You need his glory.
Yes.
Saturate our hearts. Capture our hearts, God. Saturate our thoughts. Our mind. Saturate our mind right now, God. Woo. Manifest yourself, Lord. Right now, Lord. We need you right now to manifest yourself. Don't let your glory depart. Think about it, my brothers and sisters. Without the glory of God in your life, we can do nothing. We cannot be vessels. We cannot be conduits. Oh, I just feel the Spirit in this place. Thank you, Lord, for giving us another opportunity. Thank you for your mercy and your grace and your tender love and your kindness, Lord. Don't let your glory depart from our lives, from this place, from Family Worship Center, a place where families can imagine. We don't want to leave the same way we came. Is that your testimony today? That you don't want to leave it the way you came? Is that your testimony today? Woo, glory. That's my testimony. Yes, Pastor D. That's my testimony. Is that your testimony? Do you need the fire of God to fall? Like rain. Woo. Whatever situation you're facing today. I believe you need the fire of God to fall down like rain. Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit. We invite you in, Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Yes, God. Oh, I'm on a minister, but I just need this thing to sink down in my spirit.
Send down the glory.
Yes. Shekinah glory. Do you need the Shekinah glory, saints? My brothers and sisters, do you need the Shekinah glory? Do you need the Shekinah glory? We need the glory. I think this may be Family Worship Center's theme song. Ha ha! Woo! The Shekinah glory. The weight of the glory. We need to feel the weight of his glory today. Oh, I need to feel the weight of his glory before I can minister this word. I can't minister this word without his glory. Send. Just the glory, God. Just send down the glory today. Your Shekinah glory upon Family Worship Center, a place where families can imagine the weight of your glory. We need the glory.
We need the glory.
Send down the glory. Woo. I'm just basking for a moment, saints. Is that all right with you? Woo. the weight of his glory. Yes, God. We need your glory. We need the weight of your glory. Send it down, Lord. Send it down. Just focus on his glory today. Regardless of what you're facing, just focus on his glory. We need the weight of his glory. Hallelujah. My wife has already read the scripture, and I'll just read one verse where I will be taking my lesson from this morning. The Bible records in Zechariah chapter 4, verse 6. The Bible says, "Then he said to me, the angel said to me in the Amplified, this continuous supply of oil is the word of the Lord to Zerubbabel, prince of Judah, saying, not by might, nor by power, but by my spirit, whom the oil is a symbol, says the Lord of hosts." A theme for this morning, a continuous supply. A continuous supply. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for another opportunity by your mercy and your grace to share your word. We pray that you will touch the hearts of your people. That you will touch their minds, God, that they will become laser focused on you and not on me. I pray, God, that I will hide behind your shadow today, that your vision and your spirit and your oil will be continuous upon me today as I share the word of God. Heal today, deliver, set free, strengthen, fortify, and ignite. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, this book of the minor prophet Zechariah has always fascinated me as a servant of God. It puts on full display how God will use a servant that many thought was unusable. Use a man that in the world, the eyes of the world, that looking at a man that's coming out of Babylonian captivity, that he would not be significant but insignificant. But here's how God deals with us. Regardless of where we've been, regardless of what we've done, God still has a place for you to where his oil can fall over you. This particular servant, Zerubbabel, will be the centerpiece that God will use to change the history of the Jewish nation by the rebuilding of the temple. My God. Which really, in the eyes of Zerubbabel and many, simply seemed impossible to accomplish. They were concerned that they were too small in number and too poor to accomplish the vision of restored Jerusalem. In other words, they were perceived as underdog. Have you ever been perceived as an underdog? Have you ever been talked about? Have you ever been, because of your mistakes and failures, because of your mishap, because of your wrong decisions, and because of your family or maybe the community you grew up in, they said, can any good thing come out of Nazareth? Can any good thing for myself come out of Delray, Alexandria, Virginia, which people classify as, oh, you may have been lived, you may have rose up in the projects or grew up in the projects or grew up on Section 8. And I'm talking to somebody today. Everybody was not born with the proverbial silver spoon in their mouths. Your whole life you have faced ridicule and obstacles, maybe because the color of your skin, maybe because the lack of your education, maybe because you don't know how to dot every I and cross every T. You have been considered an underdog. And I believe that the world has taken us by the mindset that you can't do nothing because you don't have the goods. It's funny because God doesn't use people that have everything correct, that can dot every I, that can cross every T, that can speak eloquently, that's a great thinker or a great builder or a great emancipator. But God will use the ones that who we think is not worthy to be used. God will use the ones who we think that doesn't deserve a second, third, fourth chance. But my Bible tells me when a man falls seven times, God will lift them back up. When a woman falls seven times, God will lift them back up. Isn't that good news today, my brothers and sisters? That it's not because of who we are. It's not because of where we've been. It's not because who our parents was. Now, they have significant readings in this situation. Yes, it's important who your parents was. It's important to a certain degree. But guess what? God has chosen you. The Bible said in Jeremiah 1 and 5, he said, before you were conceived in your mother's womb, I knew you and I formed you and I called you to be a prophet to the nation. See, yes. God will take little to make much if you put it in the master's hand.
Yes.
I thank the Lord today. Even though the work seemed insurmountable, the Bible clearly gives us the spirit of the Lord through the angel. And this whole chapter blows my mind because I begin to look at this thing from, listen, look at the oil and how they had all the instruments. When you read from verses 1 to 6, how the oil was flowing seven. One writer says 7 times 7, 49. It has so many places full. But see, here's the oil. It's just a symbol of the Holy Ghost, the symbol of the Spirit. Do you have the oil of God on your life, on your children's life, on your... Hallelujah. I believe that, my brothers and sisters, even though Zerubbabel was the prince of Judah, though a qualified leader, he knew that it would require a word. Let me say this. See, many of us are doing things on our own merits, on our own ability, on our own ingenuity, on our own greatness, on our own strength. And all of that is good in its proper context. But I believe that Zerubbabel needed a word from the Lord. So the prophet Zechariah gave him a word from the Lord. The angel spoke to him. And then he said, see, if you're going to do something amazing and supernatural for God, you need a word from the Lord. See, I understand that somebody may have given you a word this morning. They may have given you a word last weekend. And those words are good. But if it's not from a word from the Lord, then I believe that it is temporary. I believe that it's limited today.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Then Zechariah boldly declares to Zerubbabel. Then he said to me, this is continuous supply of oil. It is the word of the Lord to Zerubbabel, prince of Judah, saying, not by might, not by power.
Yeah.
But the conjunction but said, but by my spirit, of whom the oil is a symbol, says the Lord of hosts. He says to them, oh, what I love about this, and I'm going to be done too. What I love, he said, there's going to be a continuous support. My God. Everything that you lay your hands on, everything that you speak in life, everything that you believe, that even though you're under the underdog, he said, I'm going to give you a continuous support. Woo.
Yes.
You know what continuous means? That it ain't going to ever run out. You mean that what it means that regardless of the season that you're in, regardless of the difficulties that you're in, regardless of the setbacks, regardless of the bad things that have happened, the Bible said there's a continuous oil, continuous of the Holy Spirit flowing on you. Let me tell you something. We need a continuous oil for this assignment that God has called us on. at the Family Worship Center, a place where families can, and my wife and I and the people that are attached to us, you need a continuous oil to do the assignment God has called you, whether he's called you specifically or where he's called you to partner and to serve corporately. You need a continuous oil, the oil continues all the supply of the Holy Ghost. See, the reason why people are not excited, the reason why people don't have praise and don't have worship and don't have glory is because they have allowed the devil to cut off the oil supply. But God said, I'll give you a continual regardless of what the stock market does, he's still Jehovah Jireh.
Yes.
Regardless of what your body feels like, he's still Jehovah Rapha. Regardless of people come against you, he still said, I'm Jehovah Nissi. I will be a banner. I will be the provider. I will be the healer. Because there's a continuous oil that's flowing in you. If you want your church to change, my pastors, my leaders, then you need to make sure that there's a continuous oil flowing in your ministry, in your services, in every department, or every ministry, through every ministry leader. They need to have the oil of God on them, the Holy Ghost. Because see, when the oil is on you, supernatural things start taking place. When the oil is on you, people start getting saved. When the oil is on you, people start changing how they behave and how they act. You can go into a hospital full of sick folk, but if you have the continuous of God's oil, you ain't got to tell nobody you are anointed. All you got to do is walk under the oil of God, and they will feel the reverberation of the anointing of God. That's all. It's continuous. Means that there's no stopping point. It will flood you when you least expected, and we need to be flooded by the Holy Spirit today.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Woo. However, I remember being disappointed about doing things, and then the obstacles got higher. God said, you need a continuous oil, because you can't do it in your own self. You can only do it in me. See, that's what I've learned. Hallelujah. Can I give you a real quick story? Yeah. Remember in Exodus chapter 14, when the children of Israel was released, Pharaoh let them go out of Egypt, and they were walking towards the promised land. And the Red Sea, chapter 14, around verses 13 and 14, it says, then Moses said to the people, do not be afraid. Take your stand. Be firm and confident, undismayed, and see the salvation of the Lord, which he will accomplish for you today. For those Egyptians whom you have seen today will never see you again. The Lord, you will never see them again. The Lord will fight for you, while you only need to keep silent and remain calm. What that simply means, my brothers and sisters, there was an oil upon Moses' rod. There was an oil upon Moses' head. So even though the enemy is trying to take you out, even though the situation is trying to knock you down and stomp on your neck, God said, I'm about to give you a continuous oil of the anointing of God, that you will be able to never see the devil come that way again and defeat you. God said, I'll make you the head and not the tail, above only and not beneath. He said, if you trust in me, continue. See, the reason why we're not winning the battle, the reason why we don't win, is because we have allowed the devil to bring fear that causes an intermittence that happens to the continued oil. You don't ever want the oil to become intermittent. You want the oil to flow. See, there's a difference between flowing and not flowing. You know what I'm talking about. Ooh, when your marriage is flowing with the oil of God, there's peace.
Yes.
When your children are flowing with the spirit of obedience, there's acceptance, and things will get done, and you don't have this backbiting. You don't have this rebellion. See, rebellion is not of God. So the rebellion is of the devil through disobedience. And one scripture says rebellion is as a sin of witchcraft.
That's what it says.
See, but see, when you got a continuous oil that's flowing in your finances because you're giving your tithes and offerings, there's a continuous financial blessing and miracle that take place. When you are continually eating the best you can eat it and getting better at your nutrition and working out at the gym, there's a continuous health oil that's flowing through you. You look a lot younger than your age. You won't move a lot quicker than most people your age, and even the young people, because there's a continuous oil that's flowing in you, the Holy Ghost. See, the reason why we can't do supernatural things, because we don't have a continuous flowing of God's anointing, of his oil in our life. But when you get the Holy Ghost and allow it to be continued, see, the thing that can cause it to be intermittent is sin, unconfessed sin. unconfessed sin will cause it to get a log jam. Have you ever been on 95 and all it takes is one accident and then it become to a, then it looks like a parking lot? I'm talking about you need a continuous flow of God's oil. Woo, glory to God. I want to deal with three things before I sit down. Because I believe, let me read this again. I believe that the Lord wanted to infuse Zerubbabel with three principles. I love these principles because that's a part of our ministry. Encourage, equip, and empower. Three things I believe. I believe this. God gave me this message to propel him to complete his assignment by the rebuilding of the temple, which only could be accomplished through the continuing supply of oil. Let me read Zechariah 4, 6b, if you will. Saying, not by might, not by power, but by my spirit, whom the oil is a symbol. First of all, God wants to encourage us today. Number one, point number one, that it is clear that the rebuilding of that temple required a different type of might, a different type of infusion, a different type of strength. He wanted to encourage them that they can no longer use what they used to use. See, some of us are still using stuff that we used in 1995 and 2005 and 2015. We're still using the things that we were able to accomplish. But God said you need a fresh supply of oil in order for you to do something supernatural, in order for you to do something at another dimension. You have to allow the Spirit of God to put your intellectual ability, to put your rationalization back in the closet and trust in the limitless God, the unlimited God. He said, not by might. Not by might. Let me read this. Because you need a different force. You need something, because see, that your opponent may be using the same weapons, but he's using them at a different level now. And so you need a different anointing. You need a fresh supply so you don't so easily get discouraged, so you don't easily get afraid, so you don't easily concede to defeat, but know that greater is he that's in you than he that's in the world. My brothers and sisters, today God wanted to encourage you that everything that you tried to do in your own ability, in your own ingenuity, in your own rationalization, in your own objectivity, it's not good enough to take on the demons, to take on the war, because we are in a different place in 2020. We're going to need some extra Holy Ghost, and it has to be continually.
Amen.
Glory to God. You're wondering why, after ensuring that your family is being provided for materialistically, why your children still seem to be ungrateful or still struggling to be successful or do the right thing. Why you're seemingly to continue to struggle in your marriage and relationships. Can I tell you why? Because see, it's not by your might. It's not by the books you read. It's not by the degree. Even though it's okay that you obtain all the degrees, you need something that has a lot more TNT in it, something that has a lot more might and strength and ability.
Amen.
I often tell people, First Lady, that this life that we have in Christ is not a fleshly life. It's a spiritual life. Let me break it down. I know y'all know that, but I just want to say this, that many people in the 21st century don't believe that they are in spiritual warfare. They believe that it's because of the color of their skin. It's because of their neighbors, because of their job. But no. I need to let you know that we are in a spiritual warfare. We need to understand that the devil is alive and he's well and he's causing chaos and havoc. And for you as a believer that say you know God and don't believe that this spiritual warfare, I don't know who has fooled you. I don't know who has blinded you. I don't know who has run amok in your life. I don't know who has bamboozled you, but the Bible said in Ephesians 6:12, for we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. See, you need to know that the warfare that's going on in your home, the warfare that's going on in your job, the warfare that's going on in your church, it's not because, see, we used to use our own stuff, but you need to gather something called the continuous oil of the Holy Ghost. You need to hear that he said, it's not by might. It's no longer about what you used to use last week. What you did last week ain't gonna beat the demons that's coming at you this week.
Come on now.
You need to go back into the well. You need to go back on your knees. You need to go back in fasting and prayer. You need to go back there where I'm going to speak God's word, and I'm not going to be afraid. I'm going to let the devil know that I'm more than a conqueror. I'm the head and not the tail. I'm above only and not beneath. The greatest he that's in me, the he that's in the earth, that I shall win. I will not lose, because there's a winner in me. God always causing me to triumph.
Yeah. Thank you, Lord.
See, I often tell people, because, you know, we talk to people all the time about spiritual warfare, and people kind of look at me strange when some Christians say, huh?
Yeah.
Spiritual warfare.
Come on now.
Now, my husband is just acting up. That's a part of his DNA. No. That's a part of a generational curse. If he's beating you, if he's not providing for you, if you need to check to see, you need to understand that the Bible said that we're going to deal with some spiritual warfare. See, for those of you that don't believe in spiritual warfare, you keep on blaming that person around the corner. You keep blaming that person that you're driving on the beltway with for cutting you off. You keep blaming how they treat you on your job. No. It's because of spiritual warfare, because there's some wickedness in high places. You want to know what's happening downtown, down at Capitol Hill? It's not because we're political. It's not because we're trying to be dynamic. We're dealing with spiritual forces. We're dealing with wickedness in high places, principalities. We're dealing with demonic influences.
Yes.
See, I know people don't want to talk about that, but I'm going to talk about that. That's because I know that we need to understand, for the weapons of our warfare, according to 2 Corinthians 3:3-5, he said, for the weapons of our warfare are not carnal. He said, hold on, let me read this from the Bible. He said, for we wrestle not against flesh and blood. Oh, Pastor Dion took out flesh and blood. See, you think it's your neighbor. You think it's that person at the grocery store. You think it's that person at the laundromat. But no. See, it's flesh and blood. This is what Paul says. He said, for though we walk in the flesh, we do not war after the flesh. Oh, we got to change what we use. Ha-ha. But you need a different mic to change what you use, because you need to recognize that even though we're in the flesh, we do not war after the flesh. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds, casting down imagination and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ. See, it's not by your mic no more.
That's right.
It's not about because you can lift weights. It's not because you have a 185 IQ and that you consider a genius. See, all that is good. But the weapons that we're fighting, the warfare that we're in, none of that ain't gonna matter. See, that stuff that you used in 1970, 1980, 1990, 2000, and 2010, 2015, 2018, 2019, guess what? That ain't gonna work. You got to change up. See, somebody said, if you keep doing the same thing over and over again, and you're getting the same results, that's close to insanity. So if you think then that people don't like you because of the way you look, because of the way you speak, no. This is spiritual warfare. And see, you need to change your weaponry. You need to understand that the might that your fleshly weaponry had is limited.
Yes.
It's limited, my brothers and sisters. I'm grateful to God, but glory to God in the name of Jesus. The Bible says this. Let me say this so I move on to my next point very quickly. See, I want to encourage you to understand that your might is not good enough. Your might is limited. Matter of fact, if I were you, I would put my might on the shelf somewhere and trust in the might of God, and trust in the strength of God, and trust in the unlimited ability of God. If I were you. The Bible says, know this, in 2 Timothy chapter 3, verses 1 and 7. I won't read the whole thing. But it said in the KJV, Paul said, for in the last days, perilous times shall come. For men shall be lovers of their own selves more than lovers of God. Covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful, unholy, without natural affection, truce breakers, false accusers, incontinent, fierce, despisers of those things that are good. Traitors. See, the stuff that you used, the stuff that you tried to bring up, the stuff that you wrote down 10 years ago is not working now, because these demons has gotten a lot more sophisticated and their strength is limited, but your strength is a lot more limited with them than them, unless you get God's unlimited might, God's unlimited ability. See, that's when the atmosphere begin to change. That's when your family begin to change. That's when your job situation begin to change. That's when your finances change. That's when your church, when you walk in the house of God, you can feel the power, because it's a continuous oil that's flowing from the pulpit to the door. So you need to throw that out the window. The stuff that you use to you, you need to throw out the window, because see, we're in spiritual warfare. See, a lot of people don't believe that we're in spiritual warfare. We were talking to a wonderful young lady the other day, my wife and I, and she was talking about spiritual warfare, and we were doing some business and walking and talking, and she said spiritual warfare, and my spiritual ears went up, because I live in a time, or we live in a time, that a lot of people and a lot of churches, and I'm not picking on churches or people, don't believe that we're in spiritual warfare. And you wonder why hell is running through your home, running through your mind, running through your family, running through your children. See, here's what I'm going to tell you to do. Now, you may not believe it, but let me drop this off before I move to my next point. Because the stuff that you're using ain't working. Oh, that's not proper English. Let me just break it out. It is not working. And you know it's not working. So quit trying to say it is working, because you're lying to yourself. The only thing that's going to work is the Word of God and the Holy Ghost and the continuous oil of the Holy Ghost. That's the only thing that's really going to work in the 21st century, because there's some real, real problems out here that we can't do it in ourselves. I thank you for your ingenuity. I thank you for your brilliance. I thank you for your ability to put things together, but that's not working. I don't care if you in your own business. If your business is not working, if you're not being successful, then you need to check what you're using. You need to check your outlet, because the outlet you're connected to is not giving you the ability, nor the might that you need. That's why the Word of God came to Zerubbabel. It's not by might. So I don't care how much you think you got. You need to reevaluate to find out what's going on, why I am not doing what I need to do with great success and great effectiveness. The second one, we want to equip. The second principle, I believe that Zechariah wanted to give Zerubbabel, because he knew that the people and that the laborers that was going to take to rebuild the wall, they needed to be equipped, not just in their skill set as carpenters, as bricklayers. They need to have a spiritual equipment. They need to be equipped spiritually, rather. He says, not by power, equip. It is clear that Zechariah understood that the rebuilding of the temple would not take place in Zerubbabel's, not take place only by Zerubbabel's and his laborers' abilities and their force. I know that they were gifted with abilities and the force, but the assignment required a different level of power that was not limited by their resources or the circumstances. Woo! Because it was limited, it had an expiration. See, when our power, the power that we think we got, I know you have authority. I know you may be a CEO, you may be a CFO, you may be a pastor, you may be a bishop. All those things are great. All those labels are great. All those titles are great. But if you don't have the power of the Holy Ghost, if the oil is not continually flowing through you, then it's going to be an intermittent process and healing won't take place. Miracles won't take place. Deliverance won't take place. See, deliverance and healing, oh God, and miracles take place when the oil is continuously flowing.
Yeah.
See, he knew because it was limited and it had an expiration date. Some of us are using last year's anointing to accomplish a new vision, our new direction, our new assignment. You need to go back and you need to get restored. You need to get re-fortified. You need to get reignited with the here's the problem. First Lady Saints, here's the problem. There's a lot of people that go to churches that don't have no power. Our churches are powerless. So again, you need to check your outlet. Who are you connected to that's draining your power? See, the power source that you're using has limitations if it's in your flesh, if it's in your intellect, if it's in your capacity, if it's in your... See, God knew and Zechariah knew that Zerubbabel had a task at hand. First of all, we know that when God gives you an assignment, he will give you the power to complete the assignment. But there will be some folks that are with you that don't have no power, and they're draining your source of power, of your resource, because they don't believe that God is able to do exceedingly abundantly above whatsoever we ask or think according to the power that's in you. Ephesians chapter 3, verse 20 in the KJV. That's what it says. So who are you hanging out with? Are they powerful or powerless? Do they believe? Do they have faith? Are they are doubters and have no faith? See, here's it. They can only, some people can only have faith for so long, but when your faith needs to be extended, they unplug from the source. That's why folks leave your church. That's why folks leave in families. That's why folks leave a job, because see, they're depending on the source of the job to be the only income. Now, I'm not saying the job does not give you an income, but the job should never be your source. Your money on your check should never be your source, because that source is limited. You need a power source. Let me tell you how to get a power source. His name is Jehovah Jireh, the Lord that sees the need in advance. Let me tell you how you can access this. Bring all the tithes and the offerings into the storehouse so it may be meat in my house. Then he said, prove me, and won't I pour out a blessing that you won't have room enough to receive? And then he said in verse number 11 of Malachi 3, he said, I will rebuke the devourer for your sake. Yeah. See, that's power. See, that's not your power. That's not your antiquated mindset. It's trusting the omnipotent God.
Yes.
See, I love with this. Let me move forward. See, God knew that Zerubbabel could not get this thing done just with what he knew or what he used to know or even what he knew right then. He needed an extra source of power. Maybe his, see, when your power, when you are using only your power, all of your resources and all that other stuff that we talked about earlier, then it has an expiration date. Also, it can't go dead. Let me tell you what I'm talking about. When you have a car and you have a battery, and the battery may say it lasts 36 months, 3 years, or maybe 48 months, 4 years, or maybe 60 months, 5 years. See, that lets you know that after 5 years, there's a good opportunity where that battery may die. See, I don't know about you, but during the winter months when it's really cold, if you don't start your vehicle, if you don't ignite that vehicle, if you don't turn the ignition on and that ignites that battery and it flows through there, then if you don't do that after, see, that coldness will cause that battery to die. And God knew that Zerubbabel needed a battery that would not die. So he needed the unlimited power of the Holy Ghost and the oil to be continued. See, even though he did not start the battery, even though he did not start the car, but because it was a continuing flow, the battery never died. Even though when the car not started, even when you don't feel like it, even when you had no more strength, even when you had enough, God's anointing, the flow of the continuous, will pick you up. It will turn you around. It will cause you to run for the Lord. Even though last night you didn't want to get up this morning and come to the house of God, God infused you because of the anointing, the flow of the Spirit of God was continuous.
Amen.
Equipped. See, some of you need to be equipped, because the things that you're about to take on for the Lord, that other stuff ain't going to help. So you need a different power source. If the devil is increasing his attack, you need to increase your prayer, your fasting, your trusting, your faith walking, Bible believing, believer to trust God to do those things that seem impossible. Let me just say this to you. I heard this a while ago. I said, you know, as a believer in God, we should not be counseling demons. We should be casting them out in the name of Jesus. Let me give you scriptures, because I know people say, man, you need to understand that you've been self-reliant on your own ability, and it's not going to work anymore, because, see, your own ability cannot sustain you through the challenges of the next dimension that God wants to take you through. You need the continuous flow of God's anointing that will allow you to do something that nobody else could do, to see something that nobody else could see. God wanted to reverberate your spirit. Let me hurry. My time is moving quickly. Oh, behold, in verse number, in other words, you need a continuous flow of supply of oil. Luke 10 and 19 says, behold, I give you power to tread on serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy. Luke chapter 10, verse 19 in the King James Version. Over all of, oh, hold up, Pastor. Some of the power. Maybe two quarters, maybe one third of the power, maybe a half. He said, no, over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. Ooh. See, when you have reached into the power bucket of Jesus and the Holy Ghost, there's nothing. There is absolutely nothing that can hurt you. Isaiah 40, I'm going to equip you because, see, you need to understand that in Isaiah 40, 29, in the New Living Translation, they say, he gives power to the weak and strength to them and strength to the powerless. See, some folk need to get some more power because their power not working. Your ability to do things, your ability to calculate things is not working because it's in your natural ability. And the warfare that you're in is a spiritual warfare. So the natural stuff that you're using is not working because it's powerless. Last thing, last point. I'm moving quickly. God wants to do the third point. He wants to empower. Because he said, by my spirit. It is clear that Zechariah understood that the rebuilding of the temple would not take place in Zerubbabel's because of Zerubbabel's and his labor's own strength, power, and ability and their might, and that they needed something to overcome the challenges that was not normal because they were in an abnormal battle. When you take on the armor of God, it's a reason why he said put on the whole armor of God. In chapter 6 of Ephesians, he said put on the whole armor of God because he knew that the battle that we were battling was not going to be a natural battle. See, here's the problem. You want healing to take place in your church and miracles, then where's the power? You need to be empowered by the Spirit. He said, by my Spirit. I said, Lord, he said, no, he said, my son, what you need to understand, that all this other stuff that they're using, that's good and cute. He said, but the demons that you got to cast out, the sicknesses that I have to heal through your ability, it's because of my Holy Ghost. It's because of my power. It's because of my exousia. It's because of my dunamis. It's not because of where you've been, what you received. It's because of my power. See, the reason is that too many folks don't believe in the power of God. That's why they still living in defeat. That's why they still giving up. That's why they still quitting the church. Quitting the Bible, quitting marriages, quitting children, because they need the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Yeah, you need counseling. Yes, I understand that. But you need to be empowered with the Holy Ghost because the stuff that you use and it ain't working. You just need to be honest. Because guess what? Your opponent knows your weaknesses and they've been beating you to death every day this year. We're in February the 1st and you don't got your backside kicked by the devil because you're not walking in the power of the Holy Ghost. Listen, let me say this to you. Let me stop by and say this. I know some people are talking about the latter rain or something coming later on, but let me tell you something. If you wait for the latter, you're going to miss the greater.
Come on now.
If you wait for the latter, you're going to miss the greater. I know people are going to get upset with me, but I'm telling you right now, I received, by the help of the Lord, the baptism of the Holy Ghost and power when I was 20 years old, 19 and 20. And my life has never been the same. I haven't dotted every I, crossed every T. Sometime I didn't listen to the Holy Spirit, and I listened to man, or I listened to some theologian, and that got me in trouble. But when I made a decision to walk in God's power,
yes,
to walk in his authority,
yeah,
to walk in his supernatural ability, then I knew that I could lay hands on the sick, and they shall recover. I knew I can cast out demons. I knew I can speak life over death. I knew that I can speak those things that are not as though they were because of the power of the Holy Ghost. Let me just tell you what Acts says. Acts said, after the Holy Ghost had come upon you, you shall receive power and you will be my witnessing. Ooh. You want people to tell somebody about Jesus, but they don't have no power because the devil telling you all what he gonna do, all the stuff that he believe in, right in your face, 6 days a week, twice on Sundays, and you sitting up here believing because you're looking at the news, you're reading the papers, and see, guess what? If you had the power of the Holy Ghost, you could discern that and say, you know what, that ain't of God. It's not because of God's power. It's not because of the devil's power. It's because I serve a God that got all power. And matter of fact, because he had all power, he told me in Luke 10, verse 19, that I will have all power over the enemy. See, we ain't tapped into it. See, we have not activated the Holy Ghost because that's why we can't witness for Jesus. That's why they can tell us all the lies and stuff they did last night or last week that was immoral, that was evil, and we should have been about it. That's why we look at all these television programs that don't exemplify God. That's why we can't say no to the devil. That's why we say no to the devil. We won't be consistent because we have not tapped into the power of the Holy Ghost. And God knew that Zerubbabel, God knew that in order for the temple to rebuild, the obstacles from the enemies, the obstacles from there within was going to creep up on him. But he needed the power to say, in the name of Jesus, I cast you out. I take authority over you. You cannot have my children. You cannot have my grandchildren. You cannot have my husband. You cannot have my wife. You cannot have my church. You cannot have my family. You cannot have my job. You cannot have my income. You cannot have my resources. In the name of Jesus, I have the Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah.
So I prepare to close. The Holy Spirit empowered the apostles and disciples to do something in the earth that has never been done. When I think about Peter, yeah, Peter that denied the Lord and the rooster crowed 3 times, yeah, that same Peter. The Peter that cut off Malachi's ear, that same Peter. The Peter that God said, upon this rock I will build my church and the very gates of hell shall not, that same Peter. The Peter that said that thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God, yeah, that same Peter. That same Peter that cussed and lied and did his thing, that same Peter. But after, in Acts chapter 2, the Bible said, when they went up to the upper room and they were on all one accord, the Bible said there came a sound from heaven as a mighty rushing wind. And the Bible said it filled the room. The Spirit of God filled the room because they was on one accord. They were talking to one another. They had forgiven one another. They had loved one. The Bible said the Spirit of God fell on them and they began to speak in heavenly language and they were fire in their tongues, fire in their belly. And the Bible said these same disciples, these same, and let me talk about this same Peter. Then in Acts chapter 3, I believe, that when he was going to the temple and the beggar was outside the temple, yeah, the same Peter that was out there, him and John, they was on their way to prayer. They was on his way and this beggar began to beg. And Peter said, he said, silver and gold have I none. But such as I have, he said, rise up. The same Peter told this man to rise up and walk. And this same man that Peter laid hands on didn't give him money, but gave him the Holy Ghost and Jesus. The Bible said he began to go from limping to living. This same Peter, yes, the same Peter that never been done before. As I close, this same Peter in Acts chapter 2, around verse 40 and 41, the Bible says that this same Peter, after he had went out and told people to be baptized in the name of Jesus, and he began to preach, this same Peter, yes, the one that you kicked to the curb, this same person that you said was an underdog, this same person as Zerubbabel that couldn't, that you said would never build the temple, this same prisoner that got out of Babylon in captivity, this same person that maybe got locked up, that maybe got turned away, that maybe messed up with their marriage, messed up with it. Yet this same person, the Bible said this same Peter, the one that they said was out of his mind, one day he preached the gospel and 3,000 souls were added to the church because God empowered him through the anointing oil that was continually flowing after the upper room experience. You need an upper room experience to get the continuous flow of the oil of the Holy Ghost. This same Peter, 3,000 souls were added to the church in one day. When have we done that in the 21st century? Added 3,000 souls. What are you talking about, preacher? You need the continuous oil and the flow of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
As I close, you that have listened to me today, I don't even know where you are, but I will tell you this, that I'm not living in this earth without the continuous supply of the oil of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
As a believer in God, if you're listening to me this morning, as I prepare to close, I want to offer you a chance and a tremendous opportunity to get the continued supply of the oil of God in your life. And I'm a living witness, and I know some other living witnesses that because they have surrendered to Christ and allowed God to come into their lives, I believe that their transformation has taken place. And so today, if you don't know Jesus as Lord and Savior, let me give you a real quick scripture. And it's real simplistic. Romans 10 and 9 and 10 says, if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, the Bible said, thou shalt be saved. He said, but the mouth confession is made unto salvation. and with the heart, man believe it unto righteousness. What are you saying, Pastor D? Dr. D, man, what are you saying? I'm saying if you make a U-turn and repent, feeling godly sorry for the mess you made, he loves you so unconditionally. And coming in, now you need to find you a Bible-believing church, family worship center, a place where families can imagine. We'll love you to the kingdom. We will accept you. We will teach you. We will, first of all, we're going to encourage you. We're going to equip you, and we're going to empower you. So I pray that you have accepted him, or you're on the verge. But if you don't come to our church, you need to get into a Bible-believing, loving church that will cover you. I will not be in 2020 without a spiritual covering. I don't care. I don't care what you've done. I don't care how much you messed up. The Bible said that a man falls 7 times, but the Lord picked him back up.
Yes.
If you don't know Jesus, you can know him today. If you're backslidden, be like that prodigal son. Come to yourself. Say, guess what? Everything I tried, it ain't worked. Matter of fact, I got more problems now than I had when I was in the church. All you got to do is come to yourself like Luke 15. The prodigal son came to himself. And he said, you know what? My father's house, I can sleep comfortably. In my father's house, I can eat a good, balanced, nutritious meal. I don't have to eat. For a Jewish kid, he was down there feeding the pigs, feeding the swine, whatever. And listen, I'm not picking on your dietary plans. I'm picking on what the Bible said, that this Jewish kid who had nothing to do spiritually, not historically, with swine. He came to himself and said, I'm going back to my father's house. Come back to your father's house. Let's pray. Before we want to open the doors of the church. You can reach out to us if you go to www.familyworshipcenterimagine.org and leave your information. We will pray for you and pray with you. My wife and I, First Lady, we want to bring you into the household of faith. We want to bring you into the body of Christ. We believe that this ministry will teach you things, will equip you, it will encourage you and empower you to live your best life in Jesus. So I pray today, God, for the backslider. I pray today for the unsaved that you will save. And I pray that you will bring the backslider back and reconcile them. Right now, God, I decree it by power that their lives are changed, their lives are converted, their lives are healed, their lives are delivered. I decree it and accept it through the continuous supply of your oil, the Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus, we count it done. Amen. Pastor D is done. We love you.